musical film Katips bagged the top award in the 70th FAMAS Awards on Saturday. It took home 7 awards, including Best Picture. Katips producer Vince Tañada was hailed as Best Actor and Best Director, edging Daniel Padilla and Ding Dong Dantes. Johnrey Rivas of Katips was also named Best Supporting Actor. Katips, the movie, highlights the struggle of Filipino student activists during the martial law years. And for more on this, we are joined by Vince Tañada and John Rivas themselves. Good morning, guys.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Nice. Good morning. Thank you so much for joining us. First off, a big congratulations to you both. So how did it feel creating or being part of this film and garnering that many FAMAS awards?
You know, this is my first directorial job as well in film. I've been directing theater plays for like 30 years, but this is my first job as a director in film. And I'm so blessed to have received first time in the history of FAMAS Awards. And I guess they also told me that this is also the first time in the history of the Philippines that the same person has won Best Director and Best Actor. So we are very grateful.
Johnrey, for your part.
Yeah, it felt surreal. Hindi pa rin ako makapaniwala. Shock pa rin kami. But ito na siya. And thank you very much, FAMAS, for recognizing us.
I'm sure. So, Direct Vince, can you share with us the circumstances surrounding the filming of Katips? We know this was supposed to be out in theaters in June, but you moved it to August. What inspired the creation and the release date of this film?
In fact, in March of 2021, I decided to produce films. My dad passed away because of COVID, and I guess life is indeed short, and we really need to do films for me to be immortalized as an artist. In fact, I've been producing theater plays at wala talaga ako intention to produce films. But yun na nga, I said na talagang sabi ko, I really need to do films kasi maybe wala na ako, pero yung pelikula ko mapapanood pa rin ng anak ko at ng mga apo ko. So I decided to do films in March with absolutely no intention to utilize this for politics. Kaya yung mga sinasabi ng mga bashers, talaga, ano pa to eh, March 2021 yung ginawa namin, yung pelikula na gagamitin ko daw to para pabagsak yung mga Marcoses. But that is not true because I've done this as a musical theater play back in 2016. And this is my most awarded play. This has won in the ALIU Awards, which is the award-giving body recognizing live performances for best play. I won also for best director, and my actors won for their performances. So I chose the best play that I had, and I transposed this and made it into a movie. So ito na yon. So we also shown this last November 2021 and December 2021. But because of the Omicron variant, we decided to pull out the movie and show it just now. So to use this for political purposes, that is not even true because last elections, hindi na nga namin ito pinalabas. There were also offers from the campaigns to purchase this film and to use this for the campaign. Pero hindi ko ito ginamit because I believe in the sacredness of my art. At ngayon ko lang siya nilabas. This is the most opportune time for us to see Katips. Wala na tayong pag-uusapan politika, nanalo na yung kandidato na sinasabi natin. So let us just enjoy our freedom of expression, which is enshrined in our constitution, and let's just celebrate Philippine cinema.
Attorney Direct,
kasi magkalaban.
Yes, I was about to go there. And why make a movie on martial law? Why shed more light on this issue na marami na rin
namang... As I said, this is my most awarded musical play. So I chose my best musical But at the same time, you know, as an artist, it is also our objective, not just to entertain people, but more important than that, we are here to educate. Mm-hmm. So we also want to educate the young people about the atrocities of martial law. Medyo nakalimutan natin yun eh. Nakalimutan natin in the last elections. And I guess we also have responsibility na makapagturo at malaman ng mga kabataan yung mga nangyari noong mm-hmm. panahon na yun. Mm-hmm.
And Johnrey, for your part, di ba? What have you learned? What new things have you experienced working on this project?
Sobrang nakakatuwa kasi of course we got a chance na makausap yung mga victim ng martial law at itong mm-hmm. we can never invalidate their feelings talaga kaya kung sila mayroong version ng history nila pero yung history kasi hindi siya it's a fact so hindi siya nababago, it's not a chismis, so kaya para sa akin masaya ako at I am very happy na nakasama ako dito sa project na ito at with Direct Vince guidance and lahat ng mga taong nagtulong-tulong to put up this content. Maraming salamat po.
Mm-hmm. And Attorney Direct Vince, we know this is a martial law film nga, as discussed. Many movies about the Marcos regime have since been made. What makes Katips different or should I say new? Fresh?
Yeah, this is a movie musical. So it's mm-hmm. not... It's very rare for us Filipinos to see movie musicals being made here in our country. And more important to note, yung pagka-musical nito, you have to listen to the music because most of the dialogues are sung. Mm-hmm. So
much like theater, people, no?
Yes, or a lot of people in Twitter have said that this is the Les Miserables of the Philippines. So this is something mm-hmm. that we should be proud of. And this is something that we should see kasi nga bihira tayo makakita ng ganito. And FAMAS has awarded this as the best picture of the year. So aside from the educational factor about martial law, this is we also have to consider its artistic merits. Siguro bago naman sa mga Pilipino na mapanood natin yung mga pelikulang katulad nito.
And how was your experience securing theaters for the film showing? Did you encounter any challenges? Kayo ba ay actively doing something to have it shown more in theaters, have more people see it, maybe giving out bulk tickets?
we don't have the money to do that. This is my first film that I produce from my hard-earned money as a lawyer. I saved for 20 years para sa pelikulang ito. Kaya nga, kahapon, we had the courtesy call with Mayor Joy. I said, I'm sorry, Mayor Joy, I don't have any invitation to give you, but just buy our tickets if you want to see mm-hmm. the film. Kasi talagang the purpose is for us to, kahit papano, mabawi naman yung ginastos namin as a first-time producer. This is a movie of many firsts. This is my first directorial job. This is the first acting job for Johnrey. And mm-hmm. all our creative staff, even our cinematographer, our production designer, our musical director, this is their first job in film. We've been doing this for theater though, but for film, ito yung unang beses. At ang ma-recognize at ma-awardan ng FAMAS, talagang napakalaking bagay para sa amin.
And Johnrey, are you at liberty to tell us a little bit more about the movie's plot? You know, without giving much away, because this is your first acting job pala, no? For a movie.
Yeah. For movies, yeah. Yeah, nag-act na talaga ako sa theater 10 years mm-hmm. na. Talagang na-discover ako na Direct Vince. But siguro ang katips ang kailangan nilang abangan is this is a love story more than anything, more mm-hmm. than politics or whatnot. But this is a love story between usual people or ordinary people nung time at era nung 1970s. So I guess yun ang kailangan talaga nilang abangan. Kung paano nagkabit-kabit yung mga characters with this at kung paano nila nalagpasan yung journey nila nung dark era ng martial law. Kaya dapat makita mm-hmm. nila yung katotohanan na ito yung mga naranasan ng mga ordinary mm-hmm. people.
Okay, one last question for you both, but we'll start with Attorney Direct Vince. No? How do you react to a certain personality calling your movie a victim? And what do you think is, what aspect of filming a movie that depicts history is most important when you're a filmmaker and when you're an audience viewing it? What should we bear in mind when watching movies depicting history?
Okay, first, with that certain personality, we don't want to mention his name though, but you know, we focus more on the blessings. I know part of the success are criticisms from people, and we've been receiving a lot of bashing from different kinds of people, and we appreciate the bashing because in a way it would help the film. Publicity, whether good or not, is still publicity. But I always choose my battles, so I don't want to comment on his criticisms about me, my personhood, and about the film. For Katips, considering that this is an educational film, this is more of an advocacy film, I hope all our audience will understand that history is something pedagogical and academic. Hindi po ito chismis. Hindi po pwede na sabihin na ang kasaysayan natin ay nababalot lamang ng mga pag-uusap ng mga tao. Nagsasaliksik po ang ating mga iskolastiko at academicians para dito. Huwag po nating maliitin ang kasaysayan sapagkat sa pamamagitan lamang ng pagtanaw sa ating nakaraan nating lubusan, may tutuwid ang ating kinabukasan.
Johnrey, anything to add?
Wala sinabi na ng direct, so wala kami, bahala na po sila. Basta panoorin na lang.
Maybe promote, yes. Promote nyo na lang.
Ayan, yan.
Katips. Tomorrow na ang show.
Yeah, bukas. Tama po. Bukas na bukas na po ang Katips sa mga sinehan, SM Cinemas, and mamaya po maglalabas kami ng other cinemas, may Ayala Malls and Robinson Malls. Kaya abangan po nila lahat. And follow us sa mga SockMeds namin, Philippine Stagers and Phil Stagers Films, para po malaman nila yung mga kung saan kami pupunta to visit tomorrow at sa mga susunod na araw. Sana po, hashtag Katips and all our social media platforms.
Right, exciting things ahead. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, Johnrey Rivas and Attorney Director Vince Tañada. Stay safe.
Thank you.
Thank you.